want to put three or four, or that would be, would be painful, and, I wouldn't laugh, but, that would be extremely hard to do. I would think, I'm gonna look at Mike, I would think that, we could, one additional for each district, the second one would get tougher, but we could rehire. And that would be the caveat that you have to be ready for, would be that if each district reduces two more, it might be that we were hiring one more back in each district next fall.
Yeah, I hope we'd have an influx, and maybe we'd have to hire several back.
Yeah.
You know.
That's absolutely right, and we might look really smart if all of a sudden six kids in one grade move out too, and, you know, we don't have some extra staff. I would say, and you would know this already, because it affects you guys as well, when we start to look at these, it's very hard to disengage yourself from the people. There isn't anybody on the list for reduction that, it doesn't have to do with whether I personally like or dislike them. I hope that you would always trust that, but it's very hard to take yourself away from these are people we work with every day, you know. I don't know why I said that, because you wouldn't know that way. There are people that are your friends and relatives, and that affect your kids and kids, and, you know. The only emphasis I would put on it would be that what one district does, I would make a recommendation that the districts do the same as far as additional cuts if you're going to make them. And know that we can rely on our recall right to walk back to those additional cuts and say reverse seniority and job performance. And there's a plan and a process to do that, and I feel comfortable with that in those master contracts. So.
Can we agree on cutting two more FTEs from each one of these districts?
Well, that isn't really, I don't think that's really where I was going with that whole conversation. I don't want to see two more people cut. I just want us to be able to protect ourselves as a district if something happens in the state of Iowa in the next few months.
And frankly, though, I think that's the only way we can protect ourselves is by cuts. So I think that is, in a way, it's probably a good question to have asked.
Must be the right for the legislatures and open up that lost fund to fund things other than what we stipulated.
You have to be careful about all of that, or we'll get things taken, and lose monies to things that we want for education, but before long, somebody else will be taking it too. My only reluctance about that is I like
the local options. No sex that can only be used for certain things. Maybe we need to open up that, maybe we need to go back and make the time our hands.
It won't work, though. I mean, I hate to be negative, but we've all talked to legislators about funds before and making funds available for health insurance. So, you know, we really don't cut because of negotiations, but we don't know what insurance is either. We talk about not knowing what the state of Iowa, what the health of the state of Iowa is going to be. I only know of three schools who have, there's more, I'm sure, they have their insurance, but their insurance increases are 20.2, 25, and 27%. Now, none of them happen to have insurance through the same company that we do, but those don't sound promising. So Doug, I think your question really did have merit for us to consider, as much as I hate it is.
If we allow or vote on an additional FTE per district, does that mean you have to give them pink slip right now, or does that mean that you can?
We would have to do that within the March 15th or the April 15th deadline.
Do you think that what you've done here is enough protection for the district?
The numbers you have now based on what you know at the present time, right? I've been taking into consideration anything that may happen in my board.
In the company.
That would be based on, you believe there's going to be 2% funding for 4% allowable growth. know, we believe that there won't be any more across the board cuts, but I don't know.
I don't think there will be any education.
Does that allow us to tax for the additional 2%? Or we don't need to pay?
Yes, no, we can tax for that.
A lot of years, we can do it.
I guess I would give my opinion. I'd hate to see any more than one in the works, if they could work hard on any extended contract, or coaching, or anything like that in addition. I don't know about extended contracts. There might be some you can look at squeezing down some. Or not. I guess that's my opinion.
Be on the A board, and this be an easier decision for you a week from now than it is tonight. You know, I would entertain a motion to add one FTD to our reduction.
You know, I guess, surely, yeah, I don't want to see one additional person go. I mean, this in no means means that when we end this process, we're going to decrease one additional staff. We may find next month when we look at our other staff members, maybe there's some cuts that we can make, further cuts in whatever it is, whether it's coaching or non-certified staff or whatever. I guess at this time it's a thing that we probably need to do. Hopefully it doesn't come to that. You know, in the years to come, I think we need to be very careful on what staff will decrease in, because our main objective is to educate our kids in the classroom. If we continue in Iowa the way we are, that I really think we need to look at our classroom teachers first, and we need to look at some of those other areas for the cuts in the future. Just my own thoughts. But I think what we're doing tonight is I think we're going through a process that we need to go through in order to be financially